Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about the SWEET32 attack, how it constitutes, and how security issues can be prevented. So let's get started. The SWEET32 attack is a cybersecurity vulnerability that exploits block cipher collisions. Attackers can use 64-bit block ciphers to compromise HTTPS connections. While block cipher algorithms like TripleDES and Blowfish have been widely used as a mode of encryption for popular security protocols, the probability of SWEET32 vulnerability is rather low because it entails ensuring several other conditions to execute a successful attack. The SWEET32 attack is based on a security weakness in the block ciphers used in cryptographic protocols. It's similar to the RC4 attacks in terms of computational complexity. At the same time, block ciphers are used on many occasions. OpenVPN has as the default cipher Blowfish. Almost all HTTPS web servers support the TripleDES algorithm. Protocols like TLS, SSH, and OpenVPN often use block cipher algorithms for encrypting the data that travels between web servers and clients. The most common algorithms include TripleDES, Blowfish, and AES. In them, the transferred data is chopped into chunks of a certain length, blocks, instead of encrypting the plaintext bit by bit. The blocks are then encrypted in a specific mode of operation. The block length of the cipher algorithm differs from the key's length. The algorithm sets the block size, so even if you opt in for a large key size, it may still be limited by the cipher. In the TripleDES and Blowfish algorithms, the block size is 64 bits, while for AES, they are 128. The shorter a block size is, the more vulnerable it is to a birthday attack, a type of vulnerability based on the birthday problem in probability theory. This makes 128-bit ciphers like AES more secure. Short block sizes make web servers vulnerable to hitting the same hash for multiple inputs. By observing data exchange between a web server and a website for a longer period, remote attackers can recover secure HTTP cookies. In a nutshell, how secure a block cipher is based on the key size K. When an exhaustive key search attack has a complexity of 2K, it can effectively reveal secure data. For CBC, 3-day CBC ciphers, and similar modes of encryption, CTR, GCM, OCB, and others. When block ciphers encrypt large data volumes, the block size NA is also a security factor. Such block ciphers can encrypt only a fixed number of blocks, after N blocks of data are encrypted with the same key, before causing a collision between two cipher blocks in the output, producing an identical ciphertext. This would lead to the same input, which can make it possible to obtain the plaintext blocks of the secure data. In the case of 64-bit block cipher algorithms, a collision attack can happen after about 32 gigabytes of data. If an attacker generates a sufficient amount of data by using JavaScript that sends a high-speed stream from the browser to the web server, they can get access to HTTP session cookies. Still, experiments showed that as much as 785 gigabytes of data might be needed for a practical collision attack. This made an attack scenario not so easy to execute. Karthikeyan Bhargavan and Gettin Lurent, researchers at INRIA, the French National Research Institute for Computer Science, discovered the vulnerability in 2016. Their trials showed that an HTTP session cookie could recover in under 2 days using the long observation method. The categorizations include CVE-2016-2183 for DES and TripleDES ciphers, and CVE-2016-6329 for Blowfish cipher vulnerability in CBC mode. Cryptographers had previously known about this potential vulnerability, but the extent and speed with which it can be exploited were revealed only by the INRIA researchers. Impact. The DES, TripleDES, and Blowfish algorithms have been widely used to encrypt block ciphers for major protocols like TLS, SSH, and OpenVPN. This means a malicious user can obtain access to HTTP session cookies under the right conditions. The conditions include prolonged monitoring of traffic and executing JavaScript in the vulnerable browser that entails persuading a user to open an attacker-controlled website. Since OpenVPN was using the Blowfish algorithm, this made the vast majority of VPN users vulnerable to the SWEET32 attack. The TripleDES ciphers were quite popular with HTTPS web servers. However, these servers would still have a cipher preference for stronger encryption for sessions with modern browsers. That's why the INRIA researchers discovered that only 1-2% of HTTPS web servers rely on a weak cipher like TripleDES. Of them, only 0.6% have the wrong configuration, which puts them at risk of SWEET32 attacks. Most servers are configured to give preference to stronger cipher suites. This makes the triple DES vulnerability not that common. Still, high-profile websites that accept a minimum of 1 million requests in the same connection, such as eBay, NASDAQ, Walmart, Amadeus, banking websites, and more, were at risk when the SWEET32 attack vulnerability was discovered. Post-discovery actions. When the SWEET32 vulnerability was discovered and publicly announced by security experts, major web browsers, OpenSSL, and OpenVPN had to take measures to address the security risk. This put pressure on software vendors and developers to replace vulnerable versions and introduce strong ciphers. As a whole, no specific action was recommended for regular users. OpenVPN users could change their settings to more regular rekeying through the Renegbytes configuration directive. To prevent SWEET32 attacks, you must ensure your systems use only strong ciphers with large block sizes. A modern block cipher would rely on a higher number of blocks. You can refer to Secure TLS configuration for more information on configuring suitable cipher suites and minimizing the chance of block cipher collisions. Want to verify the level of security of your web app or API? Try Crashtest Security's SSL Vulnerability Scanner to detect vulnerabilities quickly and to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, subscribe to the Crashtest Security Channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.